Okay, so we have perhaps one of the biggest Cloud Code updates yet, which includes a brand new model, Cloud Code for desktop, and a bunch of other things that we'll be going over in this video. But before getting started, it's worth mentioning that I have a Black Friday sale going on my Cloud Code Masterclass, which will be linked down below with a coupon code as well. It's probably the most comprehensive resource you'll find on Cloud Code outside of the official Anthropic docs. And in the Masterclass, I do share a bunch of bonus content and strategies that I haven't shared before on my YouTube channel. Anyways, first of all, we now have Opus 4.5, which is 3 times cheaper than Opus 4.1 was at $5 per million input tokens and $25 per million output tokens. And I think that finally makes it usable for some people and means that you won't hit your rate limits quite as much. It is now the best coding model in the entire world on SWE Bench Verified and also on SWE Bench Pro, which is an even harder version of this benchmark made by Scale AI. So they haven't added it to a list on the right-hand side here, but you can tell it will be the best model in the world once it is added. And one thing that stood out to me is that now its novel problem-solving ability via RKGI2, I think is now best in the world, so beating Gemini 3 Pro and also GPT-5. So I actually want to try this on myself to see how well this performs. So there's been a pretty persistent bug with my application HyperWhisper that I haven't been able to solve for some users. There's a Black Friday sale going on right now for the application as well, linked down below. And some people have switched over to application from bigger competitors because they just prefer it. Anyways, the persistent bug has been like this one over here, affecting 51 users. And I have no idea what has been causing this bug for people. So what I did is I got GPT 5.1 Max High from Codex CLI, that's a mouthful, to basically look through Sentry and figure out what the problem is here. And it proposes a few different problems. So after about 3 or 4 minutes of thinking, it came up with this. This was pretty useless. Then I tried again, it came up with this, also pretty useless. Then I tried again with this, also pretty useless. And I was like, okay, well, clearly a GPT 5.1 Codex, this is a pretty novel problem, it's not solving it. So then what I did is I gave the same problem and the events from Sentry and the HyperWhisper code to GPT 5.1 Pro, and after 41 minutes of thinking, it basically came up with a few set of possibilities. And I was honestly pretty surprised by the result over here, because it identified problems that GPT 5.1 Max High was not able to identify, and then gave a bunch of solutions for them as well, and you can see like all its thinking over here. And this is probably the longest time that I've gotten GPT 5.1 Pro to think for so far. So I want to basically see if Opus 4.1 is able to come up with a pretty similar solution, or if it identifies something completely different. So I'm basically going to download the same Sentry events that I gave it. And you want to make sure you're on the latest version of a Claude, so just run a Claude update. And I think right now it's a version 2.0.52. And then switch to Opus 4.5, which is now the default recommended model. So press enter here. And then give it the same file, and then copy over the same prompt that I gave the other models. Press enter. And then we'll see if it actually finds what the issue is. And I suspect that it may be able to do so because the novel problem-solving ability is like pretty good here. Anyways, whilst we're waiting to see if it gets it, there is now an update in the Claude desktop app. So if you don't already have that installed, we now have Opus 4.5 in the app. And we also now have Claude Code, the like web version of Claude Code built in. So if you go to sidebar here, and then previously if you just clicked on code, it would redirect you to the web version of the application. But now if you update it, now you should see a toggle over here, and that allows you to run Claude Code in a preview version, so install runtime dependencies. Then you can either run a session on your computer with a local Git worktree. And if you don't know already, Git worktrees basically allow you to have multiple Git branches checked out at the same time. So you can work on multiple like things independently without having to duplicate the folder. Or you can have it running on the cloud with any of these environments that you create here. And then you can resume that with your computer or your phone from the Claude web application or the mobile application. Anyways, let's kick off a task here as well in a brand new worktree. And then using HyperWhisper, I'm going to say, can you find a bug in this code base and then go ahead and fix it? And that will transcribe what I just said, and then press enter. And that will kick off in a local worktree. And then basically if I show the hidden folders, I can see a worktrees folder, and then I can see what it's coding inside of here. Anyways, this is pretty nice and I will be using it more often, I think. I didn't like having big sessions running on the cloud version of Claude Code because I like having like big tasks running locally instead. Anyways, going back to what we gave Opus 4.5 earlier, the same problem, you can see it's used about 44,000 tokens so far, and that's probably with my claude.md file as well. And then basically it identified these problems over here, and it seems to have identified some of the problems that GPT-5 0.1 Codex Max High was not able to identify. But let me just do a quick comparison of this to GPT 5.1 Pro and what it was able to identify, because I think the main thing, the AppKit modal loop, is actually the same thing. Okay, so I basically got Nano Banana Pro 4K to generate a comparison between the two solutions. And solution one is the one that Opus 4.5 came up with, and solution two is GPT 5.1 Pro via the website. But yeah, I don't think this diagram is actually that useful, so let's check Opus 4.5. And it says the comparison of the two solutions, they both identified the same issue that GPT 5.1 Codex Max High was not able to identify earlier. Resolution 2, which is what GPT 5.1 Pro came up with, distinguishes between diagnostic noise and real issues. And interestingly enough, even Opus 4.5 thinks that solution 2 that GPT 5.1 Pro came up with is a better analysis of what the underlying problem was. And then also GPT 5.1 Thinking thinks the exact same thing to use it as a primary reference. So honestly, I think that may just be because it fought for significantly longer. So I'm actually curious if I do get a better approach if I tell Claude Opus 4.5 to UltraThink, because I think maybe some part of like how long it's actually thinking has some kind of impact. So let's just quickly say UltraThink, and that will increase the amount of thinking budget tokens that are available to Opus 4.5, and we'll see what it comes up with. So yeah, I think one conclusion here is that Opus 4.5 seems better than OpenAI's GPT 5 Max Codex High when it comes to problem-solving ability, but not as good as GPT 5.1 Pro. And one thing that seems to be good about Opus 4.5 is on SWE Bench Verified Pro at medium effort, Opus 4.5 beats Sonnet 4.5. So we have Opus 4.5 on medium over here compared to Sonnet 4.5, and it actually uses less output tokens. So that probably means that in some cases, because it's using less output tokens, you may find using Opus 4.5 will be cheaper than Sonnet 4.5 for certain tasks. Okay, now UltraThink is done, and of course it did not take 41 minutes. I think it took about like 6-7 minutes, but yeah, let's give it back and compare the solution. So I'm going to say compare with solution 3, compare with solution 3. And of course, I don't want to tell the model like who came up with what solutions. So I just say solution 1, 2, and 3. And yeah, actually telling Opus 4.5 to UltraThink in Claude Code, which increases the reasoning budget effort, may actually be a better solution because it seems to cover things that the other solution seems to miss right over here. So it does get some things wrong, or like it misses out on some things, as Opus 4.5 says here. And then probably it's ideal to combine the insights from all of his solutions. And this is where solution 3 diverges from 1 and 2. And it basically claims that there are many like Fred sleep events here, blah, blah, blah. And then it ignores some stuff. And yeah, honestly, like I think if you're going to be using Opus 4.5 for a pretty hard problem, telling it to UltraThink will cover many of the same points and also uncover more insights as well. Anyways, as for things that people online were saying, I vibe coded an iOS application this weekend that any frontier model can build in one shot. But the special thing about Opus is it kept on adding features and fixing bugs and never once fell down into a rabbit hole of errors or found myself with hopelessly confused spaghetti code. It just kept working and working and working. So I actually am building a mobile application as well for Hypospa that should be out before the end of the year on iOS, hopefully. And I'm going to try Opus 4.5 to see how well it performs, because if it just keeps on going and going, that should be pretty good. Someone else does seem to say that this does not apply for Opus 4.5, where the intelligence like drops massively when using more context. So maybe you can push it to like 70-80% context on a task and still have it perform pretty well. But we'll have to see with time. Anyways, I will be sharing more of those thoughts within my community, and that will be linked down below if you are interested in joining. It is free to join, and if you want to upgrade to the paid one, then I do teach a lot more about like vibe coding and making money from vibe coding there. And then someone online also says they get pretty incredible hero sections generated from Claude 4.5 Opus. So they got Claude 4.5 Opus to generate 10 landing pages, as you can see over here, and it seems to be better at design without like having to use a front-end design skill. So this is a prompt that they said they used, and they used UltraThinking as well. And if you do want to learn how to make Claude Code a better designer, then I do have a previous video about it as well that will be linked down below. Anyways, as for some other quick Claude Code updates, Pro users can now purchase extra usage for access to Opus 4.5, but maybe I won't see that option because I'm a max user for $100 a month. Plan mode now builds more precise plans and executes more thoroughly. So if I go to perhaps slash usage, so this is like what is currently right now. And it seems I have an extra usage button as well. So when I do extra usage, it takes me over here and I can pay for extra usage. So if I turn this on, then I'm not sure how the billing works here. But yeah, it seems that I can top up my account to cover some extra charges. I think this is kind of good for some people who want it kind of like in between the free plan options instead. They also now added a readline style control Y command for pasting deleted text. And that basically means that if you say like, hello, my name is Ray, and then you press control U to then delete that line, you can then press control Y to then restore the line that had just been deleted. And that's probably most useful for people who use shortcuts quite a lot. They also now allow you to send background tasks to Claude Code on web by starting a message with at shift 7, and that gives me at, and then say, find a bug and fix it. And then that will initialize the background task on the Claude Code version on the web. And then I can resume the session later by using this command or monitor the tasks by doing slash tasks. And that is the remote session that is running, which is pretty good. Or I can click on this and then go directly to task that's happening. And it seems that some of the context that you have had in the previous conversation may actually be passed through to the web session. So you can see when I say find a bug and fix it, rather than trying to find a brand new bug, it just fixes a bug that it identified earlier on in the session. But I wish that you could see more clearly what was passed on to the web session. And then there just seemed to be a couple more bug fixes instead, so nothing really important. But yeah, if you are interested in mastering everything to do with Claude Code, then I cover everything to do with that in my Claude Code Masterclass. There's a Black Friday sale going on right now. Link in the description down below. And also my application HyperWhisper does have a Black Friday sale too right now. And a lot of people have been finding it pretty useful and switching over from competitors. And then of course, I will be sharing more of my thoughts on Opus 4.5 in a couple of days of testing it more in my free community that will be linked down below. And yeah, if you do like this kind of stuff, then do like the video and subscribe to the channel because that lets YouTube know that this is a good video. And when I have another video like this, then YouTube will recommend that to you.